In this video, I show you how to parse complex documents with 5 different tools to create usable data for AI agents. To reflect real-world complexity, I chose documents like NVIDIA's financial report, medical records with MRI scan, and research papers. For the tools, Andrew Ng, Agentic Extraction, Docling, LlamaParse, and more. I also built a rag with ChromaDB and LangChain to compare the actual quality of extraction. I'm Mayim, PhD with 20 plus years in AI, teaching thousands to build AI agents in 90 plus countries. So the first one is the 130 pages NVIDIA document, the finance document. So for our code, we just need a bunch of API keys, the Llama Cloud API, and also the Vision Agent API, which is for Andrew Ng agentic extraction. And then we can go ahead and load the page. Just before extracting that, let me show you. This is the NVIDIA 130 pages PDF. It has a table of content. It has complicated graphs, and it has lots of tables. As you can see, financial tables. But also in the first page, things like logo can be quite difficult for extraction. So why are we interested in these PDFs? Because we see very often that the agent confidentially tells you, hey, Apple revenue is $47 billion, when the actual number is actually $94 billion. So it swapped two rows silently. And that's in 68% of extraction. Error in financial documents is hallucinated numerical values. So if we look at the data in enterprise, about 10% is structure and 90% is the so-called dark data that are in PDFs and scan documents. So in other words, we have 68% at least here problem. So that's why we want a better extraction for such a big PDF in our files. Back to our code, let's take a look at all of our extracts. They are all here in the extract.py. 5 methods from LandingAI, from Andrew Ng, DPT, Docling, LlamaParse, unstructured IO, and PDFPlumber. The first one is the DPT of Andrew Ng, pre-trained transformer. The only thing that you need to do is just import parse and then pass the PDF path and get the result in Markdown. The next one is Docling, which is also extremely famous from IBM. The way it works for Docling is document converter, then you convert it, and then you export it to Markdown. Just a little bit of, pass a bit of formatting. Next one is LlamaParse. We get Llama. We say our result type is Markdown. Load the data and get the result in text. Then unstructured IO. Again, the PDF path. We get the partition PDF from unstructured partition PDF. Use it, find the elements, and then join all of the elements. Last one is PDF Plumber. This is like the classical read page by page, append it, extract table, and then put everything together at the end by a text part. Then we've got extracts all of that in a dictionary and loop over it and extract all of that. And then at the end, we can print all of the extracted methods. So the most popular one is actually the most recent one, Andrew Ng's DPT, Document Pre-trained Transformer. The way it works is the model breaks tables into structures first. So cells and the position of that, then extract data from isolated sections. It can work parallel, and as you guys have seen, it's just 3 lines of codes. And they care about the structure first, so you will just do that multi-level header. They would look at the hierarchy, then they will decompose everything, break it into small pieces, as I said, and create that parallel extraction. And most importantly, it has also visual grounding because of the bounding boxes around each of the pixels, and they just say that's the place they will get the attention. So let's take a look at the extraction and see if we can see this element back or not. So if we look at DPT, the first 1500 character, the first thing that we notice is it has identified logo. And further in the extraction, you will see that none of the methods is identifying the logo of NVIDIA. Remember, if you remember on the page, we had NVIDIA logo. When we are running the extracted, the next method is Docling, also really famous. We barely have a project this famous. So in about 1 year in 40,000 plus stars. What IBM says is that Docling can do parsing of multiple documents, any document you can see, advanced PDFs, unified representation of formats, and a list of all of the advantages. So Let's see how is the extraction going at our side. By the way, I made one module of my paid course, AI Agent Mastery free. It's 30 minutes, zero to hero deep dive, and you will learn how to build AI agents. And if you want, you can also join my 5-in-1 AI Agent Mastery to build real-world AI agents with 9 different projects. All of the links are in the description. And as you can see, this is just a little bit less character, 595,000 in comparison to DPT. Let's take a look at output. It looks a little bit more messy. Do you remember we had the table of content? This one, I said that's going to be a problem. You can see this is really a problem. This is the table of content for DPT. As you can see, the items are just neatly. This is like a way better table of content than the one that Docling extracted. The next method is LlamaParse, and it didn't extract it well. It gave a very fast timeout. So you immediately can see it has a little bit of problems with very big PDFs. We can look at the extraction, but unfortunately it's not complete. Next one is unstructured. It just doesn't use so much of separators, just eliminate them inside. And then this is where it makes a complete soup out of that table of contents. The last one is PDFPlumber. It's such a lightweight library. It just gives you results in so many situations. It has a decent amount of stars and has been written by Jeremy Singerwine. Let's take a look at extraction, table of content, also less of the separators. And as you can see, although it's very lightweight, really beautifully put that table of content and also extract all of the links very well. Just keep this one in your toolkit. So the next thing that you could do is to put this PDF in a rack and ask all of the questions from it and see if it's working. But before that, let's just try actually to extract other documents that I promised. The paper itself is about 148 pages, but I took one complex page, which is this one, and I wanted to see how good or bad the extraction is done with this page. We just use the same code, extract with all of the methods. Then I noticed something about DPT. It shows that API is valid, but I don't have any credit anymore. And then I noticed that only by just using this one document, I've used 1149 credits. It's a lot of it. And these are actually the subscription plans. So DPT, although sounds like a very good option, seems to be insanely also expensive. One document, one trial, about $10. For the rest of documents, I just pass DPT. As you can see, Docling is not extracting anything. LlamaParse, looking at this page full of information, is doing a really great job and it's just extracting that. So you can see just giving me that it was an overview of domain expert agent. This complicated one pagers can be really good for Llama Index. Unstract actually failing and PDFPlumber as well. Then we go to a medical lab report. It's this data that you have different, and I have just downloaded one of them because they are real world documents. Let's take a look at the extractions. So Docling is extracting a lot of information. Does not showing it in a very good way, I should say. It's just a bit of soup. He's extracting the information, but it doesn't keep the logic. LlamaParse just making very beautifully a table. So LlamaParse is really good in this one pager complicated stuff. Unstructured and PDFPlumber both fail. Then I've got ID card. I got it from here, but I'm not quite sure if it's legal to show it. They have all of these test images. Let's don't show the ID, but I show you the extraction. So Docling didn't come with anything useful. As you can see, it was a German ID, and you can see that the names and birthday is just extracted. This is public data from Kaggle, but let's don't show the ID itself. Unstructured nothing, and PDFPlumber also. Then let's go to MRI of a brain. Also from Kaggle, picked data of this MRI brain. And you can see in MRI scan, you have always like a small text. I wanted to see how all of these are reacting to an image with barely some text. It's from this MRI images from the brain tumor. Let's take a look at the extractions. Barely anything from Docling. LlamaParse showing a part of it, unstructured nothing, and PDFPlumber nothing. So on images, they are really not that great on extracting the text. I think when it comes to those kind of images, you better use vision models. Vision models, they have longer latency, they are expensive. It takes longer to just extract information. But at least for now, we don't see that much of information coming back from the PDF extractors. So imagine that we wanted to create a rack for each method to ask actually questions. You need to know what are the steps of the rack. I have already explained that in another video in my channel. But very short, if you want to build a financial advisor with RAC, you just parse your PDFs and then get those in a text splitter. Then you change them to number with embeddings and then you put them in a database, because then you can just do a similarity search. Most of the time you use ChromaDB for a vector database. And finally, you can just do multi-query retriever, and then you've got the financial advisor. That information can become your audio. You can use 11 Labs and create this very interactive advisor. So let me just show you how to implement what I just explained with LangChain ChromaDB. So here are all of the libraries. You've got a Chroma, a character splitter. We'll start with creating a vector store. Got our splitter. Give the chunk size, split the text, the OpenAI embedding as embedding. And then we can here retrieve the information as a retriever from the vector database anytime we ask a question. And this is a prompt, the chat prompt template from the template. And finally, we use a chain from the LangChain, which does prompt LLM and the str output parser. And this is the way actually we build a rack. And then we can also compare the rack performance for different vector databases. We can add that. And we can also score the result by showing, for example, the ground truth, meaning an example and the answer, and then just compare it. And then we have displaying a result in the table. So it's pretty straightforward. So we can build the rack. Then I start asking questions. I started with a number of questions, a lot of them getting wrong answers. Then I started with just one question, a lot of not found, except for the PDF plumber. It came with the exact numbers that I wanted. And this is where it's not anymore about your extraction, but also your retrieval plus your reasoning. So be very careful when you're extracting. Then you put it inside a rack, because you split it. And any split can just also cause that disjoint of information. And if you just make the chunks too big, it's too much of information, too little, it's just too fragmented. And I tried different embeddings and different size of chunking. I made chunk size way bigger and the number of K higher. And then DPT start to win when the other ones still are not giving any information except the PDF plumber. Docling, LlamaParse, and unstructured didn't give any good information. Even I improved my embedding and chunking, and PDF plumber in general stayed a stable thing, and DPT is an expensive alternative. And when it came to one page information, then it was LlamaParse and Docling that gave a lot of good results. In none of my tests, unstructured came out as something special. Then I thought, let me just improve a little bit also on LlamaParse. So I made a verbose is true, because it gives a timeout. So then the problem was resolved for LlamaParse. But then I noticed that I had to use another embedding, which was not working very well for DBT or PDF plumber. So it's really important to work with your use case. There is no such thing that Docling is amazing, DBT is amazing. None of them are just the magic box. Each of them are good with a set of parameters. You have to really play around with those parameters. So just out of the box, I noticed none of them is working. As an AI engineer, data scientist, AI professional, need to still set the parameters for your problem. Otherwise, you would not get any good result. So that's the comparison and the way I noticed, especially when you are working combined with RAC. Remember that you do not have only the problem, which is extraction, but also retrieval plus reasoning. And those three problems get combined, and then you need to resolve those problems separately. PDFs are just one type of context that you can give to your AI agents. And we have other types of contexts like prompts and tools. And that's the context engineering. And I have these seven methods of context engineering for production AI agents. And you can watch that video and I see you there.